हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज मिस्टर विपुल संसारे। वंस अगेन वेलकम यू इन आवर न्यू वीडियो लेक्चर। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी अ न्यू टॉपिक रिलेटेड टू द फार्माकोग्नोसी, दैट इज माइक्रोस्कोपी ऑफ रावल्फिया। सो वी विल सी द सिनोनिम, सोर्स, देन केमिकल कंस्टिट्यूएंट्स, देन ट्रांसवर्स सेक्शन, पाउडर माइक्रोस्कोपी, माइक्रोकेमिकल टेस्ट एंड सम केमिकल टेस्ट यूज फॉर द आइडेंटिफिकेशन ऑफ द रावल्फिया। So this is very important topic as per the competitive examination like a GPAT concern. So just see the synonym of the Rawalfia. So this Rawalfia is known as a serpentina root, also known as a sarpagandha in Marathi, then also known as Indian snake root, and also known as a chota chant. So these are the four different synonyms of Rawalfia. Just see the source, these are the roots and rhizomes, which are a dried one of Rawalfia serpentina belonging to family Apocynaceae, and it is collected from these Rawalfia serpentina plants in autumn season from a plants of age 3 to 4 years. So most important thing, the family of Rawalfia is Apocynaceae. Also, we have studied some alkaloidal containing drug, that is vinca, that is Cathranthus roseus. This Cathranthus roseus also have family Apocynaceae, and Rawalfia serpentina also have family Apocynaceae. The most important thing, just see the chemical constituent. So these Rawalfia roots and rhizomes contain the alkaloids as a major chemical constituent. So contain 0.8 to 1.3% of alkaloids in Rawalfia. So alkaloids like reserpine, azmaline, then serpentine and racinamide, the four different alkaloids are there. Out of these four alkaloids, the reserpine is a major alkaloid contained in the Rawalfia, and this alkaloid in Rawalfia are of indole alkaloids. Means these alkaloids contain the basic ring, that is indole ring, heterocyclic ring in their structure, and which are synthesized from amino acid tryptophan, the most important precursor for the synthesis of the Rawalfia alkaloids, that is tryptophan as a amino acid precursor, because these are the indole alkaloids, that is contain the indole ring in their structure, that is basic heterocyclic ring. Now this Rawalfia is used as an anti-hypertensive agent. It is helpful to lower the blood pressure, so it is used as an anti-hypertensive agent and also used as a tranquilizing agent, the two important uses of Rawalfia. So this is up to the synonym, source, then chemical constituent and uses of Rawalfia. Just see the transverse section of Rawalfia root. So this transverse section you can divide into the three different zones. So first is periderm. So periderm contains cork, phellogen and phellodem, three important sections in the periderm. Next, second is the secondary phloem, and third is secondary xylem. The secondary xylem contains the xylem vessels, xylem fibers and medullary rays. So these are the three different sections. The first is periderm, which contains the cork, phellogen and phellodem. Next, the secondary phloem. The secondary phloem basically contains the starch grains and calcium oxalate crystals. Then third important zone, that is secondary xylem, which contains xylem vessels, xylem fibers and medullary rays. Just see the cork, the first important component. This cork is a 1 to 7 layers of small cells, you can see in transverse section. These are the 1 to 7 layers of small cells and contains the combination of both unlignified as well as lignified cells in cork. Next, the phellogen part is the indistinct part of the periderm. Next, the phelloderm. This phelloderm contains 10 to 12 rows of elongated parenchymatous cells, 10 to 12 rows of elongated parenchymatous cells. Here you can see in phalloderm. This phalloderm contain few starch grains and calcium oxalate crystals. Starch grains and calcium oxalate crystals are present in phalloderm. Next, the secondary phloem. This secondary phloem is unlignified, contain the unlignified cells. So this contain the sieve tube, then phloem parenchyma and starch grains as well as calcium oxalate crystals. So calcium oxalate crystals and starch grains are present in both phalloderm as well as in secondary phloem. Just see the third component, that is secondary xylem, which contain the xylem vessel, xylem fiber and medullary ridge. So xylem vessels are lignified vessels in Rowlfia with dimensions are 350 micron in length and 50 micron in width. So this is the dimension of xylem vessels in Rowlfia. So these are the lignified vessels. Next, the xylem fibers, these are also lignified with pointed or bifurcated ends, that is xylem fibers. And the medullary rays are extending from the center to the cortex. The medullary rays from center to cortex and contain 1 to 5 cells in medullary rays. The most important thing here, the stone cells are absent. The stone cells are absent in Rowlfia root as well as in xylem. This is the most important microscopic characteristics of Rowlfia. You can see here in cinnamon, what we have studied in cinnamon bark, the stone cells are present, which is the important microscopic identification characteristics of cinnamon bark. But in cinchona bark, the stone cells are absent, and in Rowlfia also the stone cells are absent. This is the most important thing. So the stone cells are present in kurchi bark as well as in cinnamon bark, which is the important identification characteristics, and absent in Rowlfia root and cinchona bark. This is the most important microscopic, that is powder microscopic characteristics of Rowlfia. Just see the powder microscopy. So the powder of Rowlfia shows the different microscopic characteristics. The first is cork cells. So these cork cells are isodiametric cells and sometime lignified. You can see here, these are the isodiametric cells, that is in cork cells. The second, that is parenchyma. This parenchyma is a lignified parenchyma containing xylem parenchymatous cells with starch grains. Here you can see the starch grains are there in parenchymatous cells of Rowlfia. This is again important identification characteristics. Second, the xylem fibers, these are the thick and pointed or bifurcated end. Here you can see the pointed end as well as bifurcated end in Rowlfia xylem fibers. The xylem vessels, these are the lignified xylem vessels and oblique end walls. Here you can see the oblique end walls of the xylem vessels of Rowlfia, and these are the lignified xylem vessels, the again important identification characteristics of Rowlfia powder. Next important thing, the calcium oxalate crystals, the prismatic calcium oxalate crystals are present in Rowlfia, and spherical starch grains with star shape hilum is present, is important characteristics of starch grains in the Rowlfia. And other important thing, that is stone cells are absent as we discussed earlier. So prismatic calcium oxalate crystals and spherical starch grains, again important, two important microscopic characteristics of Rowlfia powder. Just see the microchemical test, as we discussed, that is cork is lignified as well as xylem vessels are also lignified, which shows the pink color in presence of fluoroglucinol and concentrated HCl 1:1 mixture. Then starch grains are there, which shows the blue color in presence of iodine. And other three important microscopic characteristics, that is microchemical test for the calcium oxalate crystals, that is same as we discussed in previous drug. So like in Kurchi bark we have discussed. So the dilute acetic acid, the crystals are insoluble. In presence of dilute hydrochloric acid, the crystal get dissolved. That indicate the presence of calcium oxalate crystals. And in 60% sulfuric acid, the needle shaped calcium sulfate crystals are formed. That is the conversion of calcium oxalate crystals to calcium sulfate crystals in presence of 60% sulfuric acid. This is again important microscopic microchemical test of Rauwolfia powder. Next, as this Rauwolfia contains the alkaloids we have studied, that is reserpine is a major indole alkaloids in Rauwolfia. So these are identified using general chemical test for alkaloids like Mayer's test, drag and drop test, Haggar's test, Wagner's test. These are the four basic tests used for the identification of alkaloids. The similar simple basic test can be used for the identification of alkaloids in Rauwolfia. As such, there is no any specific test for the identification of alkaloids in Rauwolfia, but you can use the simple and general chemical test for the identification of alkaloids in Rauwolfia. Just see the substitutes or allied drugs. So this Rauwolfia is substituted with Rauwolfia humitoria, the first substitute. This Rauwolfia humitoria is also known as African Rauwolfia. The microscopic characteristics of this African Rauwolfia is 5 discontinued bands of scleral chymatous large vessels. Discontinuous band of scleral chymatous large vessels, which are absent in the Rauwolfia serpentina, the most important thing. So you can identify the Rauwolfia humitoria in Rauwolfia serpentina by using this microscopic characteristics, that is scleral chyma large vessels, discontinued band. Second substitute, that is Rauwolfia densiflora. This Rauwolfia densiflora also contains scleral chyma, and this scleral chyma is absent in Rauwolfia serpentina. So you can identify whether your Rauwolfia serpentina powder contains the Rauwolfia densiflora or Rauwolfia humitoria. These are the two substitutes based on the microscopic characteristics, that is scleral chyma. Both Rauwolfia humitoria and Rauwolfia densiflora contain the scleral chyma, but this scleral chyma is absent in Rauwolfia serpentina, the most important thing. Next, third substitute, that is Rauwolfia tetraphylla. This Rauwolfia tetraphylla contains the uniform cork, the first microscopic characteristic. Second, abundant sclerites and fibers and absence of racinamine. The racinamine is present in Rauwolfia serpentina, but it is absent in Rauwolfia tetraphylla. The cork cells are uniform cork cells, but in Rauwolfia serpentina, cork is a stratified isodiametric cork. So these are the difference between the Rauwolfia serpentina and Rauwolfia tetraphylla. Again, important microscopic test used for the distinguishing between the Rauwolfia serpentina and Rauwolfia tetraphylla. This is uniform cork and absence of racinamine. Just see the question which has appeared in previous year GPAT examination. The Rauwolfia serpentina can be distinguished from the other substitutes or adulterants of Rauwolfia species by. So which has the microscopic characteristic used to distinguish between the Rauwolfia serpentina and substitute or adulterants? It has asked in question. So as we discussed earlier, the starch grains are present in Rauwolfia serpentina. The calcium oxalate crystals are also there in Rauwolfia serpentina. Then trichomes are not present in Rauwolfia serpentina as well as in other substitutes of Rauwolfia. So trichomes can be used for the distinguish between the Rauwolfia serpentina and adulterants. So only one thing is remaining, that is sclerites. So this lignified sclerites is present in adulterants. So it can be used to distinguish between the Rauwolfia serpentina and adulterants. So correct option is option D, that is presence of sclerites, because starch grains and calcium oxalate crystals, these are present in Rauwolfia serpentina and other substitute also. So these two characteristics can't be used for the distinguishing between the adulterants and Rauwolfia species. Trichomes are absent in both adulterants as well as in Rauwolfia serpentina. So three options you can neglect here. So only one option is remaining, that is option number D, that is presence of sclerite. Second question, just see, this racer pine is derived from, as we discussed earlier, this is indole alkaloid racer pine. So only one precursor, amino acid precursor, is there, that is tryptophan and tryptamine.